this charge, I could reach nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
"Look here, brother, who you jiving with that cosmic debris?"
Now who you jiving with that cosmic debris? Mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo, but he told me right then when the top popped open there was nothing his box won't do with the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo. He said, "You might not believe this, little fellow, but it'll cure your asthma too." And I said,
"Look here, brother, who you dabbing with that cosmic debris?"
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? And your preparations and ram it up your snout.
"But I got a crystal ball,"
he said, and held it to the light. So I snatched it all away from him and I showed him how to do it right.
I wrapped a newspaper around my head so I looked like I was beat. I said some mumble jumble then I told him he was going to sleep. I robbed his rings and rocket watch, and everything was a bomb. I had that sucker hypnotized, he couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him his future then, as long as he was hanging around. I said,
"The price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down.
Now, is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know you could make more money as a butcher? So don't you waste your time on me.